the weak in view. Focus, Africa. Africans must take charge of their collective destiny. Like Bob Marley said, and I quote, "If you know your history, then you would know where you're coming from." Therefore, any African with a good knowledge of Africa's terrible past in the hands of the West and her ongoing struggles with the tragic consequences of European imperialism today, that is still blind to the threat that Imperial China poses to the growth, development, and future of Africa and Africans because of its hypnotic economic diplomacy with shackles of debt and flagrant disregard for human rights encapsulated in it, is either ignorant, intellectually bereft, or a mercenary driven by a genocidal economic opportunism. Africa needs herself and her conscious people within Africa and around the world now much more than it needs anybody to define herself at this crucial and critical moment in her history, to avoid being colonized once again, as the imminence of that is in the horizon, which, if allowed, would lead to the gradual annihilation of the African humanity. I make bold to say right now and right here that the presence of a delegation of Chinese doctors and nurses in Nigeria is an affront on the collective sensibility and sensitivity of Nigerians, as it is one of many strategic plans China has designed to colonize Africa that Nigerians must resist with every legitimate tool available to them. Yes, we have had a month full of stories, all disgusting, annoying, and depressing stories about Africa and Nigeria. The coronavirus fraud at the University of Ilorin Teaching Hospital. The Delta State coronavirus cover-up and update. Chinese racism against Africans, especially Nigerians in China. The coronavirus social security scam in Lagos. The arrival of Chinese medical team to Nigeria. The billionaire's donation to the federal government of Nigeria that the people are complaining have not reached them. The mysterious fire in the office of the Accountant General of Nigeria. What is happening to Nigeria? Let us go. Some days ago, we received a news about a man who returned from the United Kingdom and went to Ilorin. He presented with signs and symptoms that are consistent with someone who has the deadly coronavirus. A doctor, a professor of pulmonology at the University Teaching Hospital at Ilorin, took him under his care, during which the man's condition deteriorated, and he brought him to the hospital, used his position to bulldoze his way to the emergency room, where the man was attended by a team of doctors, nurses, and other healthcare workers unprotected. With his influence, because of the man's deteriorating breathing problems, he got a team of anesthesiologists who intubated him to open his airways. A few minutes after that procedure, the man gave up and was confirmed dead later. Again, this doctor used his influence, smuggled the patient out of the hospital, hurriedly buried him in accordance with the Islamic rites. He took all his medical records, switched off his phone so he was unreachable until after he committed the act of burying him. And perhaps in the process of burying, he may have made other people to be exposed to him, to the dead body, with virus flying all over the place. Investigations continued that led to the hospital authority collecting sample from his wife. And when the sample result came, his wife tested positive to the virus. That was how this heinous crime against humanity, this act of genocide, was enacted. Guess what? The name of the professor of medicine is Professor A.K. Salami. Somebody who has attained that high rank of professorship in medicine under normal circumstances. A doctor who took the Hippocratic oaths to save and not to kill wouldn't have been involved in this type of evil driven by nepotism. And now thousands have been infected. Nurses, doctors, and other healthcare givers, and the general population in Lauren definitely have been infected by the act of this wicked doctor, this rogue doctor, this quack doctor. This is how bad things have gotten in Nigeria. Why did he do this? Over money or over what? And to make matter worse, this man, from report, is not even in police custody. Somebody who committed this type of heinous crime should be held in protective custody right now. To get himself ready for what is to come after he's successfully prosecuted, because this offense is a capital punishment offense. This is one evil too much. One evil too many in Nigeria. Happening at this very dangerous moment in our nation's history. How can this be explained away? Will anyone come to his defense over this genocide? Where is our Minister of Health? Where is our federal government? Why is this man still not in custody? What is happening in Nigeria? Why? This is sad. He may have been doing this. There are many rogue doctors like this, killing and maiming in Nigeria. In all the government hospitals, all you see corrupt doctors. You go to them, they want you to come to their house first to bribe them before they will attend to you. If you have surgical problems, you're going to have to go pay them money at home. And then they come back and get paid by the government salaries that they used for work not done after they have used the government equipment to perform surgeries or render other forms of treatment with the money in their pockets. Nigeria is so corrupt, so loose. Everywhere you turn, everybody is corrupt. They are talking about policemen being corrupt. Have you ever been to the hospital to see the massive corruption that is taking place there? Doctors, government doctors, I would say 99% of them are involved in this scam. This one has just been exposed. But sadly, a lot of lives, a lot of people will be put through agony because of his greed and wickedness. Up next is China. I did a story on China a couple of days ago. What the Chinese officials, security agencies are doing to Africans in China. Africans are being evicted from their homes, from their hotel rooms, and thrown into the streets, homeless and hopeless. China. The same China that is all over Africa, plundering our resources in active connivance with our government officials. To the extent that Chinese officials, Chinese immigrants to Africa, those who are visiting for one type of thing or the other in Africa, have now summoned the audacity to be physically and mentally abusing Africans. We just saw one a few months ago that took place in Kenya, for which he was deported. And I can tell you that many more have happened before then, and more are still happening. So they are attempting to colonize us. They are not allowing our people who live in their country the right to live under roofs. They blame them for the disease that they created in China. They blame Africa. They blame Africans as those who brought the coronavirus from Africa. Can you hear that? The whole world knows that the coronavirus was a biological weapon developed by China in its desperate bid to control the world and become the next imperial power after the United States. So why are we paying the price for all this that is happening? All this that are happening. Where are our heads of state? Where are our African leaders? Where is President Muhammadu Buhari of Nigeria? Where is Uhuru Kenyatta of Kenya? Where are they? Where are they? Africa has been sold. The Chinese have come and have been acquiring African corporations. Zambia is gone to China. China has acquired the Zambian airport. They have acquired the historic Zambia copper mine, the mainstay of the Zambian economy. All African national assets are going one after the other to the hands of the invading and rampaging Chinese. And African leaders are quiet because they are corrupt. A lot of them have gone to collect money from China. They have placed unborn generations of Africans in debt overhangs that they may never be able to pay in their generation. How long are we Africans going to fold our arms and allow this voracious, merciless imperial power to roam free in Africa? Is it not time Africans stood up? Why? What happened that we are like this? Why are they selling our people short? Why are they killing our next generation? Why? How long shall they kill our prophets? Why we stand beside and look?
Old pirates, yes, they rabbi, sold light to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my hand was made strong by the end of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption songs, redemption songs, redemption songs.
Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. Well, have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop all the time. How long shall they kill our prophets? Why we stand beside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing this song of freedom? You're all I ever had. Redemption song, yeah.
All I ever had. Redemption songs. These songs of freedom. Songs of freedom.
Yes, how long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? It's time Africa united. Well, in front of me is a letter written by the African community in Guangzhou, China. I read verbatim. Copy Foreign Affairs Office, Beijing. Copy Foreign Affairs, Guangdong. Guangzhou Foreign Affairs, all African embassies and consulates, all African Foreign Affairs offices, CNN, GTCN, BBC, Al Jazeera, Sahara Reporters, Channel TV, African Union. In view of the current COVID-19 pandemic ravaging the entire world, we, the African community, would like to use this opportunity to sincerely commend the government of China for their prompt and effective containment of the pandemic. The central government in Beijing has provided excellent leadership, and officials down to the district level have shown dedication and commitment, which has resulted in the containment of the pandemic. The African community in China is ready to offer any assistance needed in the government's efforts to completely contain and eradicate the coronavirus in China. Our community, through various African community leadership, continues to impress on our people the importance of observing the health regulations and keeping the laws. However, it has become not only necessary but a matter of utmost urgency to inform all relevant Chinese authorities, African embassies, consulates, and organizations of the ordeal of Africans in China. Of the ordeal Africans in China are going through at the moment. The inhuman treatment, hatred, and outright discrimination against Africans that is currently going on in Guangzhou, China, is beyond expression. Before the pandemic outbreak, it was becoming impossible for black persons, including students, to rent living apartments. Many, in bracket as inconveniencing as this is, are forced to live in hotels. Now, with the pandemic outbreak, many are being turned out from their homes, and those living in hotels are being evicted. Many are living on the streets right now. We now wonder if China is at war with Africa. And where is China? Where is the China-African friendship cooperation under the One Belt, One Road initiative? From available information, we know that at least 99% of Africans tested for the virus so far have returned negative, and most have received the health certificate. Yet the story going around is that black people are carriers or potential carriers of the coronavirus. We are at a loss as to where this discrimination and hate is coming from. If black Africans cannot live in homes and hotels, refuse to admit them, and there are no flights for those wishing to go back home, what are we expected to do? A few weeks ago, Chinese suppliers encouraged their African clients to resume trade and visit China, saying that normalcy had returned. And now this is the kind of welcome they have met. We have been in China for many years and have never experienced this sort of discrimination. Inasmuch as we agree that these are unusual times, Yet it is inconceivable that black people would ever be treated this way in China. Our people are willing and have submitted to all head checks when asked to do so. Yet we are hounded as non-human beings. Today, the 8th of April 2020, black Africans living around Huikiao Garden are being threatened to be taken away to a quarantine facility even after being tested and returned negative a few days ago. As we write, about 10 African community leaders in Guangzhou are technically under house arrest using the term quarantine. These actions are difficult to comprehend when you consider the fact that these are people whose official test result came back negative just 1 or 2 days ago. Interestingly, their Chinese families are not being tested or quarantined, even though they live together in the same house. According to the report of the Guangzhou government, of the total of 111 confirmed imported cases into Guangdong in the recent time, only 25% of them were foreigners, while the rest are Chinese returnees. These foreigners are not only Africans, yet the Africans are the most targeted and subjected to all kinds of inhumane treatment. We therefore plead with the Chinese authority, the African missions, and other relevant international organizations to, as a matter of urgency, respond to this situation promptly before more lives are put in greater danger that could lead to death of innocent persons. The African community leadership and elders in Guangzhou shall continue to encourage all our people to remain calm and law-abiding, and to refrain from any form of breakdown of law and order, despite the current challenges. We continue to assure them of our confidence in the ability of the Chinese government to restore normalcy that would allow Africans to continue their lawful businesses in China, especially in Guangzhou. We are convinced that China needs Africa, even as Africa needs China. Signed by all African community in Guangzhou. This is the sad chapter of the Chinese-African relationship. Do we have to be in this? After going through slavery, after going through colonialism, after going through apartheid, and now we are dealing with the consequences of globalization that has further reduced us to less than human. Why can't Africa unite? Why can't Africans within Africa and around the world? When I mean Africans, I mean all Africans, including the children of slaves who were stolen from Africa and taken away from the soil of Africa. Why can't they forge a unity like Marcus Garvey once tried to make happen? Why can't we come together and build the Africa of our dream and leave those who hate us alone? They steal from us. When we go to their places, they disrespect us. Why is it not time that Africans came together and say, we have had enough? Where is the leadership? We need leadership now in Africa. There is none. There is no leadership in Africa. That is why France is bulldozing and stealing in quantum, stealing our resources, killing our people, turning our people into guinea pigs. The same thing Britain is doing. The same thing all of them are doing. Imperial Europe, including the United States, they are doing this to Africans. At what moment are we going to stand up and say, we, the people of Africa, want to truly be who we are? We have to define ourselves. We have been abused enough. We have been bastardized enough. We have been pushed around for far too long. Is it not time? Why can't we make it happen? The problem of Africa is one thing: leadership. Leadership is lacking. The leaders we have are those driven by colonial mindsets. They are corrupt, they are inept, they are morally bankrupt, they are not futuristic, they are borrowing the future of Africa into stupor. At what point? When? How long? How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand beside and look? Africa. Africa is a schizophrenic, so distant from reality. At what point are we going to hem it together to set the compass sailing again? The moment is now. It is about leadership, and we must start getting it right now. China has no business coming to dictate to us what we do in Africa. Africans have no business going to borrow from China. We have the resources. They come and steal it, they process it and bring it back to us at higher cost. That tells us how stupid we are. Why can't we wake up and say no? Where are our African scientists? Where are our African educationists? Why can't we take a second hard look at our education curriculum? What are our children being taught? Mandarin? Being taught Confucius? Being taught about who? We should be teaching our history. Why do we have engineers who cannot fabricate cars? Why do we have civil engineers who cannot build roads? Why is it that there are no African construction companies in the United States? Why is it that there are no African construction companies in China? Why is it that there are no African construction companies in India? Why are there no African construction companies in Germany, in France, in Portugal? Why is it that we have become a dumping ground? Why is it that Africa has become a dumping ground for everything? We are consumers of everything. We can't produce anything. So why don't we have that offensive diplomacy, offensive economic diplomacy that we can take away from our shores to showcase at the global arena? We are always going cap in hands, but we are the richest continent of the earth, populated by the poorest people, always going cap in hands. The reason is because we don't have a leadership that is thinking. We have a leadership that is always handicapped, crying, oh, we don't have this technology. But you know what? Africans are the people driving the technologies in America, in France, everywhere. Because our leadership, we don't have a leadership with foresight. We cannot assemble those people, create the enabling environment for them to express themselves. This is how sad the African story is. So sad. We have to get away from this chain. The moment to break this chain is now. And no one can break the chain but us. None but ourselves. Africa, emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. Because none but ourselves can free our mind. None but ourselves can free our mind. And you know what? If we get determined, no atomic energy, no kinetic energy, nothing can stop us. Because this continent is ours. In 1884, they had a conference, partitioned Africa. And when their industrial revolution became a global emergency, requiring Africa's raw materials and African cheap labor, they came and then started exporting us everywhere. Now that era has gone, and you know what is taking place now? We are the ones applying to be enslaved in their lands. Why can't we build our countries? Something to think about for every African. African youths, this is where I call you, Nigerian youths. I hope you are seeing what is taking place. This coronavirus infection has leveled everybody, has leveled the world. Why can't we take advantage of this moment? African youths, Nigerian youths, you voted these people into power that have failed us and are still failing us. Why can't you have a change of mind in this next round of election? Stop voting for people who don't care about you. Stop voting for people who don't know what they are doing. Vote for people who are driven by abilities, competency, and good contents of character. That is the only way. Not the man who comes and give you money to buy your votes. If he has anything to offer, he wouldn't buy your votes. You should even be contributing money to tell him, please, come and represent us, no matter how much it costs. But when they start paying you for votes, you know they have nothing to offer. The men who buy your votes are bankrupt. They have nothing to offer in leadership. I hope you are seeing what is taking place now. If we are not careful, Africa will be colonized again. And if China colonizes Africa, what they are doing to Nigerians on the turf of China, in the land of China, will be a child's play to what they will do to us in our land. They are merciless. They don't care about human rights. They don't care about environment. You see, now I want to tell you something. Chinese are coming to set up their businesses all over Africa. You know what? Because they have been battling with America over pollution. They have the worst environmental protection records. So what they are not able now, they are removing their companies, those companies that produces toxins that increases the ozone layer, the carbon dioxide level in the atmosphere. They are bringing them gradually to Africa because Africa has no leader. The type of leadership they have are cut and nail leadership. Leadership that does not invest in science and technology. They don't even study their atmosphere. Where environmental scientists are all over the places taking samples, measuring what is taking place. No, Africa is just come on, dump it. They collect some change and expose their people to danger. Most African leaders are blind. They don't know anything about protecting the environment. So that is why they give China the leeway to do what they are doing. China is a no-no right now. The world is rejecting them. Africa must not accept them. It's time. It is time. If we don't do this now, we may not have the next generation of Africans. Or we have a generation that will be subhuman. No true leadership. We want that for each citizen. Now, next, we talk about the coronavirus fraud in Lagos. You know, before they announced the lockdown, we're hearing government after government saying that they were going to, especially Lagos state government, that they were going to provide food for the citizens for the 2 weeks they were going to be in mandatory lockdown or mandatory isolation that the government prescribed for everybody. I was so happy to hear for the first time that there is a state in Nigeria that will care for its people. So we were all expectant. But sadly, the usual Nigerian thing happened. It brought one sachet of garri for a whole community to share. Not even bag of garri. Two tomato sachets. Some grains of rice. And billions were spent on all this. Where is the money? What is the population of Lagos? But what we ask in other countries that are organized, you didn't need to go and stay on the line waiting for anything. You wake up, there is food packaged right by your doorstep. Nigerians, you keep voting for darkness. That is one of the darkness you voted for. You will pay the price. The consequences are all over. For you to see what you have been doing to Nigeria, you, especially the young people, The youths of Nigeria are the greatest problem. Honestly, as much as we love you, we have to tell you the hard truth. You are not doing what you are supposed to do. You are endangering your future by putting your support behind those who don't care about you and the next generation. You brought all these people to power. Have you learned anything? All of you are now crying. Hunger is killing us. Hunger is killing us. The moment is now. This moment is very good right now. The only thing that will pain me if people start dying like they are dying in New York and other parts of the world. This coronavirus is supposed to teach Nigerians a big lesson so that they know how to choose leadership. Because that's the problem that we have. We love that little stipend, 1,000 naira, you go and vote for a criminal who don't care about you, who doesn't even know anything about leadership. Lagos is not supposed to be the way it is. Lagos is really, I know the amount of money that comes into Lagos every day. The amount of money that comes, Lagos does not even need federal government as support. Because all the companies in Nigeria are all domiciled in Lagos. They are collecting every day. What are they doing with the money? If that little pieces sachet of rice was all the state government of Lagos could provide for its people, it is time for them to close market. It is sad. Now, we come to Delta State, my state. A lawmaker was alleged to have traveled to Germany. He came back. He refused to test for the coronavirus. Even when people alleged that he demonstrated some signs and symptoms, he had mingled with the people. He had been everywhere. Potentially endangering people. I would assume that every public official should demonstrate a high level of responsibility by presenting themselves for testing, especially at this crucial moment. He's in hiding, issuing statements when he should test. The state government has not been able to mandate him to read the riot act to him that he should test. They are covering it. So far today, we have had 2 deaths from the deadly disease in Delta. Who knows how many more is coming? This is the sorry state of that. That's another terrible state where people govern on the social media without anything to show on the ground for the noise that they make. A state populated by more sycophants than actual citizens. A state where the citizens will see black and call it white. A state where citizens are so scared of opening their mouth to express themselves. That's a fascist state, and it's so sad. Up next, the arrival of Chinese medical team to Nigeria. Why are they? What business have they got to do in Nigeria? What are they doing in Nigeria? Why Chinese doctors and nurses coming to Nigeria? Where are the Nigerian doctors and nurses? I'm not sure that they have complained that there was an acute shortage. What type of special doctors, or what do they call the experts, excuse me. So yes, they have come. Those who invited them are invited them, but Nigerians have a right and a duty to reject them. Now hear my voice. I said it. I am not scared of anybody. No Nigerian should allow any of those Chinese doctors to touch them. No Nigerian should take any medications from those Chinese doctors. No Nigerians should allow themselves to be injected any substance by those Chinese doctors and those who work with them. We have the worst Minister of Health since independence today. I would think that a native doctor should have been appointed the Minister of Health. I think a native doctor would have done a better job than this man. He doesn't know a damn thing about what he's doing. It's so sad. So please, Nigerians, I am passionately talking to you. Reject those Chinese doctors and their offer of treatment. The disease they are coming to treat in Nigeria was a disease that they manufactured in their country. The world has seen that they were responsible for that disease. Suddenly, Chinese became experts in treating coronavirus. All the ventilators they produced, how many of them are working? All the masks that they sent out, how many of them were genuine? Oh, Chinese, fake. Everything about them is fake because they are corrupt. So that is why we don't want them in Africa. You can call us any name. They are inhumane, they are racist, they hate black people. Then you come to black countries, Africa, African continent, to come and exploit them and steal their resources, give them loans that they don't need, and then you start seizing their national asset. Zambia, revoke whatever contract you have with China. Don't pay any more debt, because those debts are not due. They are fake balloon loans that your stupid officials went and signed up for. You see now, you have become slaves in your country. And that is what they want. Nigeria is their biggest target. Buhari should not sell Nigeria to China. President Buhari, please, God will not forgive you. If Nigeria becomes the next colony of China in Africa, the moment is now. For Nigerians, for real. Nigerians who have been keeping quiet. The armchair Nigerians who will go to the TV stations and analyze. They don't even have voters' registration card. It's time for you to stand up for your country. Or the next generation will not forgive you for the role your conspiracy of silence played in the annihilation of Nigeria. The billionaires, they came, the Dangotes and his gang of billionaires who have exploited Nigeria using their companies, those who have stolen Nigeria blind, those who have seized the economy of Nigeria, and then they created monopolies that nobody could break or can break. They came together, the articles of this world, all those who compromised the economy of Nigeria, they came together and started donating money. Why will you donate money to federal government? A government is supposed to be second to God. The government is responsible for the ravaging poverty in Nigeria. You donated money to them. Which account did you donate that money into? And did you give them specifics of how you wanted those money spent? Most of you stole from Nigeria, so no thanks to you for the donation. You just brought back an infinitesimal fraction of what you stole from Nigeria, either as public officials or through your corporations, your fraudulent corporation. If you own banks, those banks who charge bank charges every second for every transaction. You log into your account, they will take money from you. You log out, they take from you. And then you just give that to Nigeria and you expect us to be celebrating. You are criminals. Now, you went and donated that money to a government that has not been able to manage our economy. Actually, in active connivance with some of you. Our economy is bankrupt. The next generation will be wiped out because of your greed. You donated the money. Okay, now, where is the money? A lot of people, majority of Nigerians are claiming that they did not see any money. So what happened to the money? Where is the money? If you were sensible enough, all you needed to do was to set up a trust. Build a database of Nigerians. Flood the streets of Nigeria with food. That people will go and pick up, and that there will be no need for stampede. That was all you needed to do. Because you were lazy, because you are part of the scam, because you are part of the conspiracy against Nigeria, you made it so complex. Why are our people suffering? And you see the reason the lockdown is not working. Nigerians are still on the streets, inhaling and spreading the virus. So you created a lockdown and not a solution. So sad for you people. And suddenly, fire in the Accountant General's office. What a coincidence. What a coincidence. Just as the money was donated, maybe a week later, fire gutted the Accountant General's office. Ha! Nigeria on a try. On a try. What a country of fraud on all fronts. At what point is our people going to be tired? When are we going to be tired? When are we going to say we've had enough of this nonsense? When? For real, when? When? Where are the men of conscience in Nigeria? Where are the men of higher consciousness? Why are Nigerians so afraid of dying? You want to live forever? No, God did not make anybody. Nobody was fabricated to last forever. Now, what will you be remembered for in your lifetime? When you die, what legacy? You cannot even leave legacies for your own children. Oh, some of you have been able to transport your children outside Nigeria. I think you saw what happened with the coronavirus. Everybody is looking for a way back to Nigeria. You can't get stuck because the world is changing. Anything can happen anywhere. And then you'll be looking for home. You who have been stealing Nigeria's money and taking it to the United States, taking it to Britain, taking it to Germany, taking it to Lisbon, taking it to Paris, taking it to everywhere. Those monies will become useless in no distant time. Mark it. You steal money, you go and build companies in South Africa, employ South Africans, but you deplete Nigeria of that money. You should have set up that business in Nigeria if you were not a crooked person. And you think it's cool. The moment of reckoning is here. And none of you will be spared. Your high rise building, when people will start scaling it, you will not be protected. We don't care how many mobile policemen you have right now. When that moment comes, none of you. The moment to change your ways is now. The moment to change your ways is now. We are so disappointed in you. You let Nigeria down. You wrecked Nigeria. You destroyed Nigeria. You did not care for tomorrow. You did not care for the next generation. You did not care for Nigeria's future deeper than now. You are a huge disappointment. Nigerian people, one more time, you have a moment in your hand to take your country back. Give it back to those who can lead you at all levels. That is the only way forward. Nigerian problem is leadership and terrible followership. You have followed for 20 years. Let's narrow it to 20 years. What did you produce? Nothing. Good economies are measured by progress. Progress in one, good educational system, good healthcare delivery system, good infrastructures, and good everything. Where can you tell me that Nigeria has it? Your schools are the worst on earth. Your healthcare, your hospitals are mortuaries. Your roads are death trap. Are we not ashamed of ourselves? We call ourselves the giant of Africa. Nigeria has lost its giant of Africa status. Join me on Saturday at 8 p.m. when we do our inaugural broadcast on Nigeria Now. Nigeria Now is a new consciousness that is going to be expressed through the radio to reach those who have been starved of the truth about Nigeria and her future. Be ready to be a part of it. God bless you, and God bless Nigeria. Yes, subscribe to our channel on YouTube at Smart Mado Ajaja, and also the Nigeria Now channel on Instagram. We are at Smart Ajaja for Senate. On LinkedIn, you can connect with us at Smart Mado Ajaja. Thank you, and see you on Saturday.